Do I want to ask why Vic Fontaine is fighting for the Alliance? Or why Dr. Bashir is intellectually functional in this universe? I'm not sure, which is stupider?
You behind the crates! You can come out now.
And Quark tries to defend evil Esri from slightly less evil Julian Bashir.
Yeah, this is the problem with the Mirror Universe. Everybody's evil, it's just a question of why and how much.
And how gullible you are as a result of your evil. And in the stunning upset, the Terrans take the cloak away!
I don't know about you, but I like Al-Bashir better.
You have to forgive him. He's had a rough go of it lately. He lost a close friend in a skirmish with Alliance troops.
This has nothing to do with Jadzia.
Wait, Jadzia just died? Because her counterpart died, and I know why Terry Farrell would be in this episode, I get that, but can't she just be off station? Why does she have to die? Oh yes, and now we get evil Ezri's backstory.
You have to believe in something before you can betray it.
I believe in getting paid for my work. And you still owe me for the last job I did for you.
It turns out evil Esri is a lame Han Solo wannabe. I mean, seriously, she is so lame she would look at Captain Durgo and wish she could be that awesome.
The way I see it, you've got two choices. You can either head back to where you came from, or you can head for Alliance territory. Try to rescue your friend without the cloaking device. You have till morning to decide.
What's it gonna be?
So Quark and Rom decide to rescue Zek.
Stupid! You're so stupid!
Just as soon as we get out of this prison held by our enemies. You know, little matters. Meanwhile, on the USS Overcompensation, the evil version of Kira is locked up with Zek. How do you know she's the evil intendant and not the actual Major Kira? Why, her majestic tinfoil crown, of course!
That looks like something you'd make at a bridal shower game, where you have 2 minutes and a hunk of tinfoil to make something.
That looks like something that the people who lost that game would make.
It's when your people give the Regent the cloaking device, we'll both be free.
If Quark and Rom don't screw things up...
Ah!
Have a seat, big boy.
Since when is Mehardu, the giant guy who's Zek's bodyguard, so easy to take down?
I don't understand.
There's nothing to understand. He's my Negus. And when your Negus gets in trouble, you're supposed to do something about it.
Okay, DS9, I'll give you this. You had one good scene of character growth, even in this garbage, which just shows the strength of Deep Space Nine.
This is supposed to be an alternate universe, but their Captain O'Brien seems as nice as our Chief O'Brien. It doesn't make any sense. It's not alternate.
And then there's that. Of all characters that ought to vapor lock and shut the hell up, why doesn't Rom? So Brunt shows up to help them. Because this is good Brunt, because in the Mirror Universe everything is backward, but it ought to... Oh God, I'm becoming like him!
What took you so long?
Sorry. Been a little busy. I had to break into the cargo bay, steal back the cloaking device that you lost, and get it into our ship. But on top of that...
Okay, quit your complaining and get us out of here.
You asked him!
These fried tube grubs are delicious.
Wait, I thought Ferengi only liked tube grubs when they're raw.
Yeah, didn't Nog say something like that about Sisko's Creole cooking?
Let's run the tape on that.
I like tube grubs, and your father is the only person on this planet who can get me live ones.
Of course, I'll have to cook them for our human customers.
Cook them? What good are tube grubs if they don't wiggle on the way down?
So Brunt is actually sympathetic to the good guys, but is loyal to Esri for some reason that we're only going to vaguely hint at. And yet he's probably the best character in this episode. Ponder this. And now Worf is doing antics with the Ferengi's beetle snuff. Meanwhile, Andrew J. Robinson, who actually tries to play with, I wouldn't call it subtlety, but at least real sinister menace, is trying to play Game of Thrones while everyone else is playing the young and the restless.
You, come here. Your regent needs you. Nice fit. I want that cloaking device!
Yes, Worf is indeed a cartoon villain worthy of the 1960s Batman series. But if that was the worst that this show had, I could live with it. The Mirror Universe has always been about the overplayed, silly stuff. It's where we get stupid near the end.
Our visitors from the other universe have arrived, and I'm happy to report they have not come empty-handed.
So, they give Worf the cloak. And then Kira appears, even though she was a prisoner last seen, and kisses Ezri. Now we see why she could never date Brunt. Time for Lesbians in Space! Oh, 90s TV and your attitudes towards gay people. They weren't second-class citizens, but they weren't people either.
No, they were there for stereotypes and titillation.
The most literal of titillations. So, Ezri betrays the Ferengi and Worf arrests them. Because they're evil and everything. Muha and Ha and such. And now we find out that Zek came here on purpose after stealing Rom's plans to get to the Mirror Universe. And that's about all the exposition we're going to need here. Zek is a moron who runs his empire like a moron. The only thing that'll be worse is if you got the only stupider Ferengi that exists and had him succeed you.
I'm your Negus. You have no secrets from me.
I see what you've been doing in the sonic showers, Rom.
Brunt is regretting their betrayal and confronts the intendant. Knowing how she kills people on a whim, he confronts her. Guess what happens?
No! Now, gosh darn it, you listen here!
And now we continue the Deep Space Nine theme of, in the Mirror Universe, a Ferengi will always die. Meanwhile, the Defiant is coming after Worf in his ship, and apparently this is going to be a straight fight, even though this ship should be able to smack the Defiant all to hell.
Well, it's a very complicated piece of equipment.
One of the Ferengi seemed to know how it worked.
They demand that Rom install the cloak, and he agrees.
I'd advise you to watch your tone of voice, Ferengi!
What? You won't let me install the cloaking device?
So Rom suddenly has a spine. Okay, I'll give you that. Even this moment I like. Actually, I kind of like Mirror Garrick in general, because he's not that dissimilar from actual Garrick if he'd made different choices. Which is a good example of what the Mirror Universe ought to be.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
I have never tried that before.
Well, few men have, but I think you'll find it very stimulating.
When in doubt, pinky out.
And the cloak works. And so Worf, knowing that only one person knows how to install this cloak and just did a good job, has that person ordered executed.
That settles it. I'm never helping you again.
Or anyone else for that matter.
And so now Garrick has been ordered to execute all of the Ferengi. I told you I like Garrick. And so when it's time to kill them...
It's 10 cc's of concentrated ulcartic virus. It's very deadly.
He starts monologuing.
He starts like this prepared speech about how feeble I am compared to him, how inevitable my defeat is.
What an amateur. Excuse me. I mean compared to our Garrick.
And the Ferengi goad him in order to delay him. Again, this is actually not a bad scene. I'll stick with Mirror Universe Garrick. Let's hope he never dies. And a pointless Defiant scene, and we're back with Worf.
They have no idea that we are behind them.
Nothing like surprising them from behind. Oh, that's not what I meant!
Drop the cloak! Fire!
And it turns out Rom sabotaged the cloak because Rom outsmarted everyone here. Ponder this. And Ezra kills Garrick. Damn her. So the Defiant shows up and starts to utterly demolish Worf's helpless ship. The evil cartoon Klingon is forced to surrender and then throw an evil cartoon hissy fit. Evil Kira escapes, but evil Ezri stays behind and joins the good guys. Yay. Because after all, we'll want to see her again in the next Mirror Universe episode. Oh. Back on Tarok Nor, Deep Space Nine, the evil Worf is now a prisoner. I'd like to see what happens to him after this episode. Oh. Ezri joins with the rebels. All so she can get a peek at Lita's lesbian treats. Because after all, straight people are like that, to where they'll just abandon everything they know for the sake of sex, right? That's respectful. And we reach the end of the episode. I was never a big fan of the Mirror Universe episodes of Deep Space Nine, but this is by far the worst. This is taking everything that might have had subtlety or even just a sense of fun and drowning it into pointless titillation and Michael Bay-esque garbage. This swings for the cheap seats and somehow still misses. So, as usual, decide for yourselves. But as for me, I'm calling this one POS DS9. That's why I'm starting with me.
Godzilla, her race,
that's season 7 of Deep Space Nine!